Richard here on the staff. Our volunteers are here. Many of them are learning and training to become teachers in the planetarium. So that is a wonderful advance for us and for them, something that they never thought they would be learning as an usher here at Franklin Park Art Center. I also wanted to introduce two people here from Parks and Recreation and Community Services. Greg Davidson, who is the Division Manager for Parks, sitting there, and Jeremy Payne, Assistant Director for Parks and several other departments. So thanks to them for being here. And then our most important guests of honor, Dan and Arlene McGinnis, who are right here in the front row, with whom, with their donations, we were able to have this planetarium. So thank you, Dan and Arlene. As you will soon experience, the digital Delta IV planetarium puts a full-featured planetarium within reach, displaying constellations, zooming in and labeling objects like planets and moons, faraway galaxies, demonstrating motion, and much more to engage audiences of all ages. The portable inflatable dome that you see here supports a full projection, state-of-the-art system, which you'll see when you go inside. And the entire thing folds down into three suitcase-size portable pieces that, oops, hold on, the governor's calling. Sorry about that. I'll call him back. So it supports full star shows, full dome movies, and interplanetary discovery. Depending on the size, with students, we could probably fit about 30 students in here. With adults in chairs, it'll be probably about 20. And I have some chairs inside and some seating on the floor. So if you're not comfortable sitting on the floor, we'll just do small groups for the star show tonight, this afternoon. We look forward to starting in September doing regular monthly planetarium shows here. So look for that in our new season. And we'll be doing some this summer, most likely, as well. Dan asked me, you're gonna use it, right? And I can assure you this is not gonna sit on a shelf somewhere. We already have a group coming in tomorrow morning, so. The development of this technology really was something that allowed us to fulfill a donation that the McGinnises made to Franklin Park Art Center and Loudoun County Parks, Recreation, and Community Services quite a while ago. And their foundation idea was that as we were constructing the planetarium, maybe there would, there would be a way to include an observatory or stargazing or something like that in the facility. And structurally, we weren't sure how to make that happen. But once this technology came to be, we realized this is the perfect way to fulfill that original contribution. We brought the idea to the McGinnises, and as I said, the one question that they had for us was, are you gonna use it? And we said yes. Some of you may be wondering, what does a planetarium have to do with the visual and performing arts? And I'd like to just answer that question briefly so that you can help be our ambassadors as you go out into the community and share what you saw today. For one thing, Loudoun County Parks and Rec, one of our visions is creating community through people, parks, and program. And if you've ever been here on an afternoon, on the weekend, you'll see a lot of people outside that don't know that the Art Center exists. And if you've ever been here for a theatrical program, you'll talk to people who don't know there's a pool here in the park. So, this, I think, is the kind of program that will bring people from the outdoors inside and people from the performing arts, the indoor people, outside, and really help us enjoy everything about the park together as one larger community. And I think it will really cement our place in the wider community in terms of people really knowing more about us and about our facility. The other thing is we do many multicultural programs within our department and here at the Arts Center. We have several as well. And one of those is Tanabata, which is a Japanese festival. And if you know anything about Asian culture, many of their traditions are based on the lunar calendar. And Tanabata's story is about two stars, Vega and the Altair star, that only come together across the Milky Way during one time of the year in August. And that's when they celebrate this festival. So patrons will be able to come in, step inside the planetarium, see the night sky as it would be in Kyoto, Japan, at that time, see those stars coming together, hearing the story of the two star-crossed lovers, and really understanding it and understanding those traditions in a new way. And that's just one event. So you can see how my mind started going when we originally started talking about this almost a year ago, I guess it is, yeah. So I think you're probably ready to get the show started. Yes?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So I first need to do a little bit of housekeeping, have a few pictures for the newspapers with the McGinnises and the planetarium and our lovely sign to thank them. And of course, I think it's only fair to let them be the first ones to go in, right? so we could probably take and if you see the dipper part and the handle, so you see the handle is down near the horizon at this point. Anybody know Orion? Anybody know which one is Orion?
It's a belt, isn't it?
Yes. So his three. I didn't look before I came in.
Here?
Yes. So you can see his belt here with three stars. So now if I were to take a
projections to be seen from the outside, or is it fake enough to screen it all out?
Yeah.